standing next to the mighty Ottawa River for centuries. This was the treacherous route taken by generations of fur traders and loggers. And today, I reenact part of that route with someone who has a far more treacherous job ahead of them, selling Stefan Dion to English Canada. Bob Ray joins me now. Hello, Bob.
Hey, Rick, how are you?
I am good, sir.
Fully clothed.
Good to know.
I'm in my post-nude phase. How about you?
So am I. Let's get on the river. You ready?
I'm all ready to go.
Okay, let's do it. So, Bob, have you ever done any whitewater canoeing?
Well, I've been at a Liberal convention. Is that the same?
Lots of ups and downs, peaks and valleys. We have an expert, Paul.
Hi, nice
to
meet you.
How are you, Paul? Nice to meet you. Paul Mason.
Great to meet you. Nice to see you.
Bob Ray, what are we going to learn?
You're going to learn a couple paddle strokes, which end of the paddle goes in the water, how to keep the canoe upright, because that's a good thing.
Oh, we can do that, right?
Yeah, okay,
sure.
I've kept the canoe upright before.
And, have you?
All right, well, then you guys would be naturals.
The last time we spoke, you were running for the leadership of the Liberal Party.
That's correct.
How'd that work out?
I didn't win that one.
All right, we're looking good. Oh, look at that.
Perfect. I'm like the sperm in the Woody Allen movie. I'm here. Send me in, coach.
It's a boy! I'm just gonna let a little blood to my head about every 2 minutes, because I think that's when the brain damage kicks in.
It'd be hard to tell.
Okay, before we get in the boat and you start exerting yourself, how's the old ticker?
Ticker boom's great. Absolutely terrific.
So you had heart surgery.
I did. They gave me a new aorta.
So did you have a heart attack?
Or? No. I just had, this is something they've been watching for a while.
And
they said,
what's it called?
It's time. It's called an aortic aneurysm, which has now been fixed.
Did you tell your cardiologist you were going to do this?
He'll hear about it. I think he watches TV.
Okay, that's good. Let's get in the boat. I'm glad that you're well. Now, Bob, am I in the front or the back?
I think we're going to put you in the front as the leader.
Because I have, in the canoe, the guy in the back is the guy in charge.
Ah, you figured it out. Make it elegant. That's it. One way, very good.
It's an elegant entry. This is it. What are we gonna do?
You're gonna do a draw stroke.
We're gonna learn some strokes.
I don't like the stroke word. Can we not use the stroke word? Can we use the paddle word?
What about paddles? Like ka-chunk. You don't wanna hear that.
No, it's true. That's a sound you don't wanna hear.
Yeah. It's Bob's job to steer, right?
No, he's not totally responsible, if that's what you're kinda getting at.
That's what I was hoping
for. Don't try the my fault stuff, eh? I've been through that, okay? I've had 25 years of that. I'm not gonna do it again, all right?
If I wanna go this way, I do this. And if I want to go that way, I do this.
You got it.
I think I'm prepared. I'm good. Are you sure you're allowed to do this after heart surgery?
Paddle.
Okay, I'm paddling.
Paddling. All right.
Oh, my God. Are you ready for this, Bob?
I certainly am. Go.
Okay.
Go. Don't straight down. Straight down.
Very distinguished.
And almost extinguished.
Okay.
Good
job.
Thank you.
We went in the drink.
Yeah.
Why?
Because you guys were hammering at that hole.
Oh, yeah.
And you guys were just like full on. You hit the hole, you went up.
Yeah, I remember
that.
And
you get a little wobbly when it's in the air.
I remember that part.
Landed, yeah. And you kind of
fell out.
And we lost Bob for a minute.
No. I was just hiding out. I was hoping the camera would focus on you.
Where were you hiding, Bob?
I didn't want to be there.
You were underneath.
Under the canoe.
If your cardiologist sees this tape, he's going to snap.
No, he'll be happy.
Before we head into the bigger rapids, we should talk about the election.
Okay.
If there's going to be an election, will you be spending your time in your riding trying to win that seat, or are you going to be out gallivanting around the country?
I think I'll be spending an awful lot of time in my riding. I mean, I think...
You have a really safe seat.
There are no safe seats anywhere.
Not for the Liberals.
I don't know, not for anybody. I don't believe in the theory of a safe seat.
Well, look at Uchimo.
But not after canoeing with you. I don't believe in the theory of a safe seat. There are no safe seats in that canoe.
So you think there's a shot that the Liberals could form a minority government?
Absolutely. I think we could form a majority. I think when
oh,
you get into a...
now, Bob. When you, I mean, you know I like you and everything, but now
I have
you're,
no idea
you're talking
you like.
Crazy
you like
talk.
Me?
Yes, I like you very much.
That's very nice.
I like you very much.
That's very nice.
Well, you know, you can get in a canoe with me. I'm surprised you actually came on this trip.
Why?
Do you remember our last trip? Remember that?
We'll always have Killarney, Rick.
Yes.
It's the last time we're going to play that shot.
I promise. Look at that from here, Bob. Okay.
That was great to be with you, Rick, as always.
Got the heart a-ticking?
The heart has never been stronger. Next time,
yeah,
let's play chess.
First thing that comes to mind when I say the word coalition.
Oh, God. No, I think that's a good thing.
Coalition. Stephen Harper, he won't need it. He's coming in without a coalition.
Coalition, as we just heard, is the buzzword of the election campaign so far. It's at the heart of accusations and counter-accusations of lying and hypocrisy. Tonight, the Liberals' Bob Rae weighs in. He's the first of several senior players from different parties who will join us here on The National as the campaign moves forward. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Wendy. Good to be with you.
Thank you. So a coalition is now being portrayed as this horribly evil and scary thing. You were part, in 1985, you were part of sort of a coalition with Liberal leader David Peterson. Are they really that scary?
Well, look, I mean, this, we can go look at lots of historical examples. I just think the key thing to realize right now is that Michael Ignatieff has made it crystal clear the kind of government that he wants to lead, the sort of campaign that he wants to run. That's going to turn on the substance of issues. It's going to look at the choices between prisons and pensions, the choices between fighter jets and a fair deal for families. And that's the kind of campaign I think we've got to turn our attention to. You know, Mr. Harper has been running a very negative and fearful campaign about all kinds of bogeymen that are out there. I don't think they exist, and I think most Canadians don't think they exist. And I think it's important to look at the focus on the real issues, which are the ones that are right in front of us.
Except the specter of this coalition as a scary thing really has dominated the first couple of days. I mean,
well,
have you been outmaneuvered already? This
no,
wasn't supposed to
no,
be your issue, your
no,
agenda.
No, look, I mean, Mr. Harper has as much trouble or even more trouble now with the whole coalition issue as many as anybody else. He can fearmonger all he wants, but I don't think people like that style of government. I mean, he's misrepresented other people's positions on everything. He's taken, I think, a very negative approach to the entire campaign, and he's failed to bring it back to the issues which really affect people.
Well, and now he's using this fear to say he needs a majority to fight off a coalition.
Well, you know, I think
he's never talked about a coalition
Laurier,
before. That used to be the scary word.
No, but he has this famous letter that he wrote with Mr. Duceppe and Mr. Layton. So, I mean, he's, as they used to say, he's got a lot of explaining to do, too. I mean, I think the key thing is to realize what he's up to. He's up to a campaign of fear. He's up to a campaign of division. Now, for those of us who've been in the House of Commons for a while, we've seen this literally every day. Even today, he's saying, for example, keeps talking about how the government was defeated on the budget. Government wasn't defeated on the budget. Government was defeated because it was found in contempt of Parliament, because it wouldn't release documents that will tell people what the government is spending and how it's spending it. He says on another occasion, he says, well, the Liberals are just a big spending party that wants to raise taxes. He's raising taxes right now on a tax that everybody understands, because it's a tax on their employment. And he's telling people that, we're going to spend more money. He spent $70 billion more in this budget than he spent in his first budget in 2006.
But could it be that a coalition is, that he has succeeded in having people talking about the coalition because your leader, Michael Ignatieff, is not seen as popular enough, that people aren't comfortable enough of
Look, this
with
is,
him
this,
as a leader of a
This
coalition.
Is Michael Ignatieff's first campaign. We've all seen campaigns come and go. This is his first campaign. He's had the first few days of the campaign have gone very well for him. He's out there. Oh, he's out there talking to
and
people.
Yet, but we're not talking
crowds.
About ethics and
well,
the
big,
kind
big,
of issues you're trying
big,
to
big,
well,
get
on the table.
I'm talking about them. If you want to talk about something else, well, you can talk about that. But look, I mean, he's had 1,000 people in Ottawa. He's going to have 1,000 people in Montreal tonight. Big crowds, another big crowd out tomorrow in Toronto. He's releasing issues of substance. He's talking at first about this question of contempt and this question about democracy and the choices that people face, the choices between, you know, do you want to build more mega prisons or do you want to start providing pensions? Do you want to give tax cuts to banks and oil companies or do you want to see that working families get a bit of a break? And these are not impossible issues to understand, and they're very critical for Canadians as we go forward. This is what the election ultimately is going to turn on. And that's why I don't think Canadians are going to be inspired by this campaign of fear and misrepresentation and division, which, frankly, Mr. Harper has become quite famous for.
But he's obviously feeling more confident than he did in the last few campaigns, Mr. Harper, because he's talking about a majority.
But who's he talking to? He's not out with the public.
But it used to be a scary thing for him to talk about a majority, supposedly. That was the scary Harper
So now he's found scenario. Another. So now he's found another way of scaring people. I mean, that's why every time I look at Mr. Harper, I feel a little bit like little Red Riding Hood. I look at him and say, no, Grandma, what big eyes you have. I mean, he's constantly coming in and scaring people.
You don't think he can get a majority?
Look, I'm not in. This is for me, this is not a horse race. This is not about predicting on day one what the result is going to be on day 38. I think that's nuts. I mean, I think if the media turns its attention to that, then we're not going to really have a democratic discussion. The issue is going to be, do you want to spend $6 billion giving a break to the banks and the oil companies, or do you want to give a break to working families? Do you want to spend $30 billion on fighter jets, double the number that Mr. Harper's prepared to talk about, or do you want to have an honest discussion about how there should be a competition for whatever new fighter aircraft we get as a country?
Well, we'll see if the topic changes tomorrow. Thanks
I'm sure
so much.
It will.
Thanks, Mr. Wei.
Thank you.
Nation, I am dying to see President Obama's address to the nation tonight. I've got a TiVo, so please don't tell me how he failed this time. Mainly, I want to see it to get answers about the shocking regime collapse on everybody's mind.
Canada's coalition minority government led by Prime Minister Stephen Harper fell today.
The Canadian government has fallen. As we speak, I know a chilling story. As we speak, marauding bands of rebel Inuit are storming Parliament on beaverback. While embattled Prime Minister Stephen Harper orders Mounties to dump cauldrons of boiling maple syrup on them. It is the only story that anyone is talking about, so let's kick off my week-long coverage of
chaos in Canada.
Cut it out. I'm trying to watch the hockey, eh?
Nation, we've only begun to scratch the surface of this panic in the provinces. For more dramatic details, let's go to the BBC.
The no-confidence motion simply confirms the conclusions of a group of MPs that on Monday found the minority Conservative government of Prime Minister Stephen Harper in contempt of Parliament for failing to provide the estimated costs for a number of spending programs.
Okay, I think that's enough coverage. Jimmy, we will not be needing this graphic anymore.